My name is Chris Pistorius. I'm in the Material Science and Engineering Department. I'm also co-director of the Center for Iron and Steelmaking Research. So my research deals with metals production, iron making and steel making. We produce a lot of CO2 when we make iron. It comes out to about 2 tons of CO2 to make 1 ton of iron. We think we can do better than that by putting in natural gas into the process. In steel making, we look at the tiny little inclusions which are remnants of how the steel was made. We've got ways to find those and to try and tweak their properties so they have less of a negative impact on the steel. There's 30 million tons of iron made in the US through blast furnaces every year. That means about 16 million tons of CO2. That's the same as roughly 12 million cars. So if we can change that a little bit, and we think we can change it quite a bit, that would have a significant impact on our greenhouse emissions. As far as the steelmaking projects are concerned, it really has to do with controlling the processing properties of the steel so that we can get good deformability, good toughness, especially for the newer, higher strength steels, which are increasingly being used in automobile production. Exactly the same principles apply to other metals manufacturing as well. One of my students is working on 3D manufacturing, 3D printing of aluminum silicon alloys, and be using exactly the same microscopic techniques, plus a few extra things to understand that kind of processing better too. Steel has been around for a long time as a material. It's one of the oldest engineering materials of humanity. There are many interesting things still that remain to be done in researching iron and steel making.